Hello, this is Chris, and I am back once again with a brand new trailer reaction. This is a very last minute, very spontaneous trailer reaction. I am in work in 6 hours' time, but what is sleep when you look in your sub box and you see that the Lion King official teaser trailer is out? I knew immediately that I had to jump on a trailer reaction for this thing. This night, I could not go to bed knowing that a trailer was up for this thing, and I wouldn't be able to do a reaction until tomorrow. So, here we are. This is The Lion King. I mean, this is huge. This is arguably one of Disney's biggest films. This is, of course, the upcoming live-action adaptation of the original 1994 animated classic, which is regarded by most people to be Disney's best movies, if not one of. And this is directed by Jon Favreau, who, of course, directed Iron Man 1 and 2. And most notably, The Jungle Book, which was Disney's live-action adaptation. So he clearly proved his chops with that, and they've given him the reins to Lion King. I am a huge, huge Lion King fan. Of course, I'm a huge animation and Disney fan in general, and Lion King is definitely up there and absolutely was as a kid. I had the sequels on video, Lion King 2, Simba's Pride, and Lion King 3, or Lion King 1.5. Loved both of those as a kid. And Lion King I own on DVD, I own it on Blu-ray, and this is the OG. This is my original VHS cassette tape, very beaten, very worn right now, but I have a lot of fond memories of this particular video right here. This and Aladdin were easily my top two favourite Disney films. And with live actions, I mean, I do really want to desperately get to the trailer, so I'm going to try and keep this intro as brief as I can and then talk more about it afterwards. But with the live action adaptations, I've been very hit and miss on. I thought Jungle Book was okay. On the flip side, I really couldn't stand Beauty and the Beast. It seems they're very hit and miss. I think sometimes they lose a lot of the heart and they lose a lot of the charm of what those original animated films had. And also the fact that, like, for example, Lion King is still an absolutely solid film that is the staple in most children's upbringing and is still shown to children now. So maybe this new live-action version will reach a new audience. I think the key audience that this is going to bring in is people my age who grew up with it as a kid and are interested to see the same film essentially again, but just with this computer-animated sheen over it. It's very weird calling this a live-action adaptation when it is going to be very much computer-animated animals, probably with some live-action backgrounds and stuff like that, probably in the same vein as Disney's Dinosaur, if anyone remembers that movie from 2000, I think that came out. But with all that being said, we're going to watch the trailer together now. I absolutely cannot wait to talk about this thing. It's a minute and a half, and we'll talk much more about it afterwards. But yeah, this could go either way, so I'm going to click play now. I swear to God, though, if Hans Zimmer's music kicks in a minute, I am gonna, like, actually cry on camera.
Everything the light touches
is our kingdom.
But a king's time as ruler rises and falls like the sun. One day, the sun will set on my time here. And will rise with you as the new king.
Oh, man.
Simba.
Well, I guess it's cliche to say at this point that the CGI looks incredible. But, wow. I wish it would show the characters of what they look like with all the names coming up.
Remember.
Is it just me? It's weird seeing realistic lions with, like, brown manes. Like, I'm used to Lion King where they've been drawn in red. Like, I really wish they'd have done the red mane. I mean, it's Lion King. it's very much Lion King. I don't really know what I can say to this trailer. This is obviously a teaser trailer. It looks like if we're going with Disney films, and I'm sure they're going to pad it out more and do, and you know, remove stuff that was in the original film and change stuff around as they do with these live action adaptations. But this looks like it's going to be, from the trailer at least, more like Beauty and the Beast, in that Beauty and the Beast was pretty much, for the most part, a shot-for-shot remake of the original animated film. And I'm kind of against that. I liked, whilst I didn't love Jungle Book, I appreciated Jungle Book more in that it did obviously throw in those fan service moments, and indeed some of those fan service moments felt very out of place with the rest of the tone of the movie. I'm looking at I Wanna Be Like You, for example, with Christopher Walken, which felt, it felt like they had to put that song there because people were expecting that song to be there, but it didn't feel like it fit the place of that film. And whereas Beauty and the Beast, for example, that was pretty much almost identical to the animated film. And if you're gonna make it, and this is where I think with these live action remakes, they're doomed if they do and they're doomed if they don't, in that if they don't put in things and elements and, you know, key moments that we remember from that original film, then people are gonna go and see this film and said like, oh, they didn't put the stampede sequence in, oh, they didn't do this joke, they didn't put this character in. Because we do hopelessly pine away for that original film. And then on the flip side, if they do make it completely 100% accurate, and you know, like they've got James Earl Jones back, for example, and I know people really wanted Jeremy Irons back as Scar, they wanted all the familiar voices that we know as those characters to come back. You know, we've got Hans Zimmer coming back to do the music for the film. And if you're bringing in so many similar elements that were from the original, then it's then becomes just the original again. So why not just go and see the original? What is the point of remaking the film? And from Disney's perspective, we know what the point is of remaking these films, in that it's an easy cash cow. They make a lot of money, a lot of people go to see them, they're number one at the box office for a very long time. And I mean, Beauty and the Beast made a lot of money. This is going to make an absolute killing at the box office. Now, don't get me wrong, of course I'll be going to see this one. I love Lion King. It'll be great to see some sequence on the big screen. And I think that's what's drawing me to see it. I think with Lion King, the scope of that animated film, and I mean, it's still huge and it's still incredible. And this film won't come anywhere close to the majesty of that original film. It'll obviously tug on the heartstrings with the music. It'll obviously be lines like this in the trailer that Mufasa says that are lines that have been ingrained into our minds that we know and that we love. But that's all that's going to get us into the cinema, I think, is nostalgia. And I really don't know how I feel about these remakes, especially with films that enter the collective consciousness and are still obviously ongoing to this day. This is a shirt from the Lion King musicals, which is, you know, selling out shows pretty much every single day of the week, two performances a night. Like, Lion King is still very much around and people still very much connect with it. Do we need another film exactly of the Lion King? That being said, and then like with voices as well, like James Earl Jones, if they did go for a complete new cast, people would just immediately say, well, you can't top James Earl Jones, you can't top Jeremy Irons. And they're not going to top Jeremy Irons. Like, I like the actor they've got who is playing Scar, but I'm going to hear that voice come out of that character and that's not going to be Scar to me, because these are the characters to me and these will always be the characters. So I don't know, maybe, personally for me, I don't think I can distance myself from that original film, even going into this movie. I will very much go in and expect to see, you know, Circle of Life, the stampede sequence. I've heard rumours they've cut out Be Prepared, and I'm just thinking, why? In 2019, is it not PC to have goose-stepping hyenas now? Is that the reason? I don't know. I honestly don't know. It'll be interesting to see, obviously, the animals in more realistic live action kind of CGI, and the CGI does look absolutely incredible, but it looks like, well, it's a movie I saw in 1994 because that's exactly what it is. It's very much a remake, probably shot for shot. And a lot of people will think that I'm being very negative on this trailer. Did I hate the trailer? No. But they use an exact soundbite of James Earl Jones saying that line. And then I think towards the end of that soundbite, they then blended it into his new voice. It sounded a lot more aged and it was a slightly different intonation and slightly different delivery to the original version. And then they're just kind of showing off Circle of Life, which was an incredible sequence back then. And I'm sure this will be equally as incredible to look at as well. But it's kind of the vein of I'm repeating myself now, but it's just the fact that, yes, it's nice to get these films back, but the films haven't gone anywhere. You know, we can still very much easily watch Lion King. But then again, like, I know a lot of people, and people on the channel as well, for example, connect more with live action. Even as a kid, they connected more with live action things than they did animation. I don't know whether it was that great sense of realism or what it was, but, you know, if people connect more with that, then of course they're going to have a blast at this movie. And if anything, it's going to be like just another adaptation, essentially, of the same stuff that we've already seen. It'll be nice to hear the music again and see the characters once again on the big screen, done in a different animation style. But I've pretty much said everything I can on the Lion King official teaser trailer. Don't get me wrong, I am still very much looking forward to this film. However, I have more of a relaxed attitude with these live action remakes because I am so connected to those original animated films, what they did for animation as well, especially Lion King. It's absolutely incredible. So that'll do it for my reaction to the Lion King official teaser trailer. Be sure to comment, subscribe, let me know what you thought of this trailer. Can you not wait for this film? Or like me, are you kind of on the fence with these live action remakes? Do you think we needed a remake to Lion King? Anything Disney or Lion King related, please do drop me a comment. Be sure to hit the bell icon and that subscribe button to stay up to date with all of our latest movie reviews and trailer reactions from myself. I am going to quickly edit this now and hopefully get some sleep before I get off to work. Thanks very much, guys, and I'll see you guys on the next video. See ya.